This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. As we celebrate the great 50 days of Easter, it is a joy to welcome all of you who are present in our cathedral and those joining us on live stream for this special organ recital. I'm Rick Abala, the Director of Music here at St. Thomas More. I would like to express my personal gratitude to our cathedral clergy, staff, and to this season's COVID concert team for their patience and support, and to our generous patrons and benefactors whose names are listed in the program. We couldn't do this without you. During tonight's recital, there will be an offering collected. Your generous contribution will not only help defray the cost of this concert, but will assist cathedral concerts to continue well into the future. This has certainly been a strange and challenging year. The pandemic continues to disrupt our lives in so many ways. Our cathedral choir, youth choir, diocesan choir, handbell choir, and concert committee may be on pause, but we are not on mute. Last summer, I decided we would proceed with a COVID concert season. With our wonderful placement of our organ console, it is easy to have an organ recital with plenty of social distancing. I invited my colleague and friend David Ball, who's the organist at Christ Cathedral in Orange, California, to play for us tonight. We were planning to have Dr. Jennifer Pascual play for us next season. However, because of COVID, we decided it's best to postpone David's recital to next season and to have Jenny play for us today, since she was able to drive from New York. Both David and I are deeply grateful to Jenny for agreeing to trade with David to play for us tonight. On top of being a music director in one of the most prestigious churches in our country, Jenny is an amazing wife and mother and deeply respected by her colleagues. I am blessed to call her a friend. Please join me in giving Jenny Pascual a warm welcome.
Thank you. Thank you for being here this evening. It's great to see live bodies inside a church. I've played a number of concerts where we had nobody in the pews, but saying hello to the camera only with nobody in the church. So it's great to see you all here. Thank you for your time, and you could be anywhere else on a Friday evening, but you chose to be here. So thank you, and thank you to Dr. Rick for the invitation to be here. The first piece was by Guimont, a French composer. The second piece is by Bach, and that's a name that you would recognize, one of the most famous names in all of composition. This piece, Pièce d'Orgue, is in three parts. The first part is kind of like in an Italian style. If you can imagine a violinist playing really fast notes, that's kind of like what this is simulating. The middle section is longer in a French style, French classic style, with the resolutions and dissonances in the hands, and then a cantus firmus, or a long series of long notes in the pedal. And then the third part is again in that Italian style with the fast notes of a violinist playing, if you can imagine that, and then these pedal points in the pedal, which repeats D, 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 and then eventually resolves to G.
Thank you.
next piece, the Sonata de Clarines, is a sonata for the trumpets, or the loud stops of the organ. In this case, in Spain, it generally would have meant that they played this piece on these horizontal trumpets, which are the loudest trumpets on this instrument, as well as those instruments in Spain. It's a long piece. I'm not going to take the repeats so that I can save everybody's hearing, but it's fantastic with these really loud pipes. And in the middle section, I'll play some of the softer trumpets in the middle here. Soler was a priest, and I had the privilege of staying at the monastery in El Escorial, the royal monastery, where he was the music director and is buried there now. After that, I'll play four chime preludes by Dudley Peel. We don't know anything about his dates, but we know that Dudley Peel is not his real name. His real name is William Henry Baker, and he was an organist in Perth, Scotland, and then he eventually moved to the United States and became a teacher in Norfolk, Virginia.
Thank you.
That's one of the fun things that when I perform in different places on different organs, you get to find the fun stuff on the organ, like the chimes and the bells and the loud trumpets. It's a lot of fun to play those. The next piece is a set of variations on the Polish hymn Serdeczna Matko, and this means Beloved Mother, our Blessed Mother. And this was composed by Roland Smith. And I actually am playing this as my prelude this coming Sunday for Mass because the Polish consulate in New York likes to have their Mass around the canonization date of Pope John Paul II. And so he was canonized almost 7 years ago. So this is a tribute to him and also to mothers. And then the next piece is Ave Maria from his Advent suite of Pietro Jan. And Pietro Jan was one of my predecessors at St. Patrick's Cathedral. He's probably the most famous person to come from St. Patrick's. And if you don't know who he was an immigrant from Italy. But the most famous piece of music he's probably known for in the church world is the Christmas song, Gesù Bambino.
Thank you.
The next piece I'm going to play is a little composition I did while I was in school working on my doctorate for, I guess, a theory class. And so it's a tiny little invention, under 2 minutes. And the next piece after that is the Scherzino of Lucrecia Casilag, who was a Filipina composer, teacher, pianist, and she was known for incorporating Philippine indigenous instruments into her compositional, orchestral compositions. And she was also known for writing in 12-tone, which is a very, very dissonant style of writing. But this is not 12-tone. This is more kind of pentatonic, using mainly 5 tones. And she also taught at the University of the Philippines, but she also went to my alma mater way before my time at Eastman School of Music. And so this is a piece of music that is written for piano, but it works very well on the organ. And then after that, I'm going to play another piece, 3 in a row, The Promenade by McNeil Robinson. It's not really called Promenade. There's really no title to it, and it probably is a movement from a multi-section work, but it's not published. But he always referred to it as Promenade. And I studied with him privately for a while, and he played this for many people's weddings, including mine and my husband's, at St. Patrick's Cathedral.
Thank you.
The last three pieces on the program are for the Easter season, since we're still in Easter. The first one being the O Filii, based on the chant that you know, and you'll recognize it. The text of the O Filii is by a Franciscan from the 1500s, and the chant tune you'll know well, and that's by Jean Demessieux, a French organist virtuoso who also was a composer, and she was known for playing phenomenal scales and octaves in her hands and a crazy pedal technique. So this is one of her, I guess, easier pieces. The next piece is by Eugenio Maria Fagiani, who is a living composer in Italy. He is the organist at the Basilica in Laverna in Arezzo. And he's also well known for being an international concert artist, a judge for competitions, and he's a phenomenal improviser, and he's also a good friend. So this is his Alleluia from his seven brief pieces. And then the final is the finale from Symphony No. 6 of Vidor. I want to take the time to thank you all for coming this evening on a Friday night. Thank you to Bishop Burbridge, and also the rector, Father Patrick Posey, the cathedral staff, cathedral musicians, and especially to Rick Gabala, dear friend, who invited me here to play this evening.
Thank you.
I'll play one more piece, and you'll recognize the tune. It's a toccata on a very familiar tune, written by my friend Christopher Pardini, who I went to school with at Eastman. And he used to be at the Crystal Cathedral in Orange County in California before it got turned over to the Catholics. And so knowing that David Ball was going to be here tonight and we swapped places, I'm thinking of David and also thinking of you because I know you all know this tune.